Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Perkenalkan nama saya Rory Amanda. Saya dari kelas fotografi A. Di sini saya akan menceritakan dongeng yang berjudul Asal-Usul Danau Kembar dengan berbahasa Inggris. It is told that in ancient time, there lived a grandfather or ninye named Ninye Gadang Bahan. He worked every day as a carpenter making board from the wood he cut down. The body is straight, big and tall, and has an axe or pickaxe material the size of Nero, a tool used to winnow rice in Minangkabau. Despite being big and tall, Nene only eats once a week, but once eaten, can spend food in large quantities. Nini processed the wood directly in the forest where he cut it, then take it to the market in the form of plank to sell. From here, he supports his family. One day, Nini Gadang Bahan went back to the forest to make plans, and on the way, he was intercepted by something large, blocking his view. It turned out to be figure of hook dragon snake. Nini tried to chase him away, but the dragon was silent and even fought back. Finally, there was a fight between Nini Gadang and the dragon. Seeing the aggressive dragon, Nini started playing the material pickaxe he was carrying. This is where the legendary Minangkabau saying come out with strength and open and never shake when he meets on one he never dodges. Nini allows an attack. His skill in playing the pickaxe and the silat moves he had mastered were able to make the great dragon fall down and finally surrender. His neck was almost severed by Nini pickaxe until the dragon ran out of blood. Finally, Nini Gadang threw the dragon into a valley. After being left for some time, Nini returned to the valley where he had banished the dragon. How surprised he was when he saw the dragon that didn't die. The dragon symbolized his body by forming the number 8. The blood from his neck kept coming out profusely to redden to area around the valley. Witnessing this strangeness, the area eventually became an attraction for Ninia and local residents. But over time, the dragon body was slowly buried the ground. The two locations, the dragon circle, were flawed and formed two small lakes. Over time, the lake grew bigger to produce a beautiful lake. Sekian dari cerita dongeng saya. Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.